let's now discuss the calculation of electric field using Gauss law. About this electric field calculation, we can write down few points. Like the very first is, to find electric field strength at a point in the vicinity of a charge configuration using Gauss law, we need following steps. To be executed. These steps I would like all the students need to note down or very carefully just keep in mind. The very first point is, we consider a closed surface in surrounding of the charges such that first important thing which is to be carefully taken care of about considering a closed surface is the point is on this surface. The point where we wish to calculate the electric field, the point is on this surface, which is actually the Gaussian surface in our picture. And another is, there's also very important point to be taken care of, that is that every point of surface, electric field vector is either parallel or perpendicular to the surface. This is not necessary to apply Gauss law, but this is a very useful characteristic. If we take care of this point while considering a closed surface in the surrounding of charges, the application of Gauss law will become mathematically simpler. Another point is directly the application of Gauss law. Now we can say we apply Gauss law for this surface as integration for the closed surface, the flux can be calculated as E dot ds, and this will be equal to the sum of the enclosed charges in the surface by epsilon naught. This is the way we apply this. And how we use it, let's consider an example for calculation of electric field due to a point charge. Let's discuss on this. And then once again, we take up various cases for application of Gauss law in this situation. As an application of calculation of electric field using Gauss law, let's discuss the electric field strength due to a point charge and its surrounding. Say we are given with a charge plus Q, and say at a distance r at a point P, we are required to find the electric field strength due to the charge. So in this situation, as per the rule we have just discussed on the previous sheet, we consider a closed surface in the surrounding of this charge at which, at every point of which electric field is either parallel or perpendicular. And we also keep in mind that this electric field should remain uniform. So here I should consider a spherical surface in the surrounding of this charge which is of radius r. So we know as the electric field is radially in a radially outward direction from a point charge, so at every point of the spherical surface electric field will be normal to it. And in this situation, if we wish to find out the electric field at point P, the same electric field will exist at every point in the surrounding of this charge, which are located on this spherical surface. So here the magnitude of electric field will remain same. So here we can say, if we apply Gauss law on the surface, we can write using Gauss law for the spherical surface shown. Here we can write integration of E dot ds for this spherical surface, as it is a closed surface, it must be the total enclosed charge, which is only Q. So it must be written as Q by epsilon naught. And for evaluation of this integral, we consider a small elemental area ds on it. And as a sphere is radially symmetric, this ds vector will be in radially outward direction, which will be parallel to the electric field vector at the location of ds. So here E dot ds will become E ds cos of 0 degree, which is the angle between the two, because these are parallel. And as E is also uniform at every point for the surface, if we name this surface M, then this integration must be carried out over the surface M. Symbolically, I have written the name. So here, as E is uniform at every point over the surface, I can take this E common, and it will be integration for the closed surface MDS is equals to Q by epsilon naught. And for the whole surface M, as it is a sphere of radius R, integration of ds will be the total surface area of this spherical surface, which will be 4 pi r square. This is equals to Q by epsilon naught. So here you can see the value of electric field we are getting is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r square. That is K electrostatic constant. We can replace it as KQ by r square. The result which we already studied earlier, but now we have calculated the result by using Gauss law in the surrounding of a point charge, and we have calculated the result of electric field strength in the surrounding of a point charge.